everyone. My name is Claire Escamilla. I'm a PhD student at Clemson University in the Plant and Environmental Science Department.
And I'm Levi McCurcher, a PhD student at the University of South Carolina in the Biological Sciences Department.
And we're here to talk to y'all about floating treatment wetlands, what some of their benefits are in ponds, as well as specifically how to harvest them. And we're going to do that by showing you two different harvests that we've done. The first one is here in the upstate, where we are at a pond that drains a parking lot and some office buildings.
The second harvest is down in the South Carolina low country, where we'll be harvesting a floating wetland from a coastal brackish pond. Floating treatment wetlands are a relatively low maintenance treatment option for water quality improvement. You position them on the surface of the pond and anchor them with slack such that they can rise and fall as the water level changes within a pond. Floating treatment wetlands come in many varieties, some more naturalized like this option. However, they can be more manicured depending on what the pond manager prefers. Floating treatment wetlands are constructed by placing aquatic plants in some sort of buoyant medium such that their extensive root systems hang underneath the mat in the water column and the shoots and leaves are exposed to the atmosphere. Floating treatment wetlands may provide a wide variety of ecosystem services. This includes water quality improvement by taking up nutrients from the water column. This also can be in the form of habitat provision for a wide variety of aquatic and terrestrial creatures. And finally, floating treatment wetlands can also provide a visual aesthetic in suburban developments.
And I'll start first by saying you don't necessarily have to harvest your wetland. You are welcome to install it and leave it in there for several years like we have with this wetland. But if you are worried about nutrient concentrations in your pond and you want to make sure that you're permanently removing some of those nutrients that your plants uptake, so you don't risk it cycling back into your pond, then harvesting and removing the wetland is a good strategy. As well, if you are in an area where people don't want to see a lot of dead plant material when your plants are not actively growing, that's another great situation where harvesting a wetland could be of benefit to y'all. Another option is you can remove the whole wetland, you can compost the plant material and save the mat, and then next growing season when you want to install a wetland again, you can reuse the mat and put in new plant species. A great thing is if you use native plants to your region, then they're going to survive better as well as provide good habitat for a lot of your native wildlife in your region.
All right, so now that we've got the floating treatment wetland out of the water, you can really get a good look at the above mat environment as well as the below mat environment. Now in the above mat environment, this can provide suitable habitat for a wide variety of wildlife. It's quite common to see turtles, ducks, geese, and perhaps other critters lying on top of the mat and perhaps nesting as well. And then we look underneath the mat, we have these extensive root systems, which is largely home to a lot of different worms, arthropods, and in more coastal brackish settings, you can get clams, oysters, barnacles, and other more salt-tolerant critters as well. So all in all, these floating treatment wetlands do show some promise in providing habitat for wildlife in areas that are largely deprived of this.
When you're looking through the ponds is seeing if there's any wildlife. Levi talked about how lots of animals like to lay and make a home on these wetlands. So especially if you see ducks that are nesting or laying eggs, don't remove the wetland. Make sure that you know the proper rules and regulations. So talking to a local regional wildlife biologist or whoever has those permitting entities in your state would be a great way to learn what you need to take in account for when you see wildlife that's living on your wetland that you want to remove. And my last tip is these wetlands, even though they're floating, they're not light. So you can see that it took a lot of people to get these, even in smaller sections, to be removed from the pond. So making sure that you have multiple people on site to help you is going to help make sure that your removal is safe and as easy as possible. So with that, good luck if y'all are gonna attempt to harvest a wetland, and thank you for listening.